Hey, welcome to Graphic Policy Television GPTV on Reddit. It's Wednesday, which means it's brand new comic book day, and in my hands is one of those releases. This is Edge of Spider-Geddon, the miniseries leading up to the latest Spider-Man event, Spider-Geddon. And Marvel's been rocking it with the Spider event. Spider-Verse was awesome. They had an Edge of Spider-Verse that led up to that. Edge of Spider-Geddon was pretty good leading up to Spider-Geddon. Spider-Geddon is just kind of a follow-up to Spider-Verse. There's like these vampires who feed off of spider-type characters. They get unleashed again, and it's just all hands on deck. Spider people from across the multiverse having to fight. And what this is a bunch of spider people, you know, one-shots kind of introducing. So got Spider-Punk, which is that's exactly what it sounds. SP/DR, it's Penny Parker. And then there is Uncle Ben version of Spider-Man. And then there's also Dr. Octopus, Superior Octopus, who, you know, of course, was Spider-Man for a bit. So this includes Edge of Spider-Geddon number 1 through 4, Superior Octopus number 1, J. McKay, Lonnie Nadler, Zach Thompson, Gerard Way, Jason Latour, Aaron Kuder, Christos, Gage, Gerard, Sandoval, Alberto, Albuquerque, Tonci, Zonjic, Will Robson, Mike Hawthorne, Mark Bagley, Brahm, Revel, Greg Yeung, Wade von Grawbadger, Brian Reber, Triona, Farrell, Ian Hearing, Andres Mossa, Jordie Belair, and Dono Sanchez-Almara. A whole bunch of versions of Spider-Man, and they're, for the most part, pretty good. There's one or two that fall short. So the Spider-Punk one is fantastic. The Superior Octopus is good. It irritated me a little bit of the way they actually wrote Doc Ock. I think they're writing him better now with Superior Spider-Man. There is this Osborn version of Spider-Man, Norman Osborn. Like, that story I wasn't a big fan of. The Penny Parker one is good in that I wanted to read more. I thought the story, from what I remember from my original review, I read it again, but from trying to quote my original review, I thought it was a little disjointed in the storytelling. And the Uncle Ben one is actually, the art I think is fantastic, the Uncle Ben Spider-Man version. Basically, he gets a blood infusion, kind of like She-Hulk sort of thing. Overall, I think this is really solid. Bunch of great one-shots. And I kind of want them to do this more and more and more. I'd love to see miniseries, ongoing miniseries, rotated around exploring the various spider characters throughout the multiverse. And I think this shows the strength that they can do that. Spider-Punk especially, clearly a fan favorite of the people who are into Spider-Man. Penny Parker, clearly another fan favorite. I really enjoyed the Uncle Ben version. I would love to see that one. We can skip the Norman Osborn one. And I, you know, already we got Superior Spider-Man as an ongoing, or I think it's ongoing, might be a miniseries. So, you know, clearly we can support more Spider-Man comics. So Marvel, please, please do that. Give us some more miniseries. It'd be great. But yeah, I really like this. So it's $15.99 for all that. Show some of the art. We'll do some of the Spider-Punk. They keep on calling Spider. The Spider-Punk one is awesome. Like, it is such a great. I would love a Spider-Punk series. The Penny Parker one is a weird, kind of like kaiju-esque version of Spider-Man. I don't know how to quite describe it. Kind of reminds me of Pacific Rim Uprising, which is not necessarily a good thing. The Uncle Ben one, give you a little style of the art of that one. Actually, I really like that one. That was a cool version. And then the Norman Osborn one, there was some good about it, but overall, I think just something was lacking. But overall, really like the miniseries, even the small limit steps. It was awesome. So go get it. It's in comic shops today. It'll be in bookstores in 2 weeks, January 15th. It should be when it's released. Go support your comic shop, though. They'll have this. Good shop should have this. if you don't know if a shop's near you, don't know where a shop's near you, we got a link beneath this video putting your zip code or tell a shop near you. No shop, no problem. We got affiliate links. You can purchase through that. There are affiliate links. So we get a small percentage of that. Doing that, you also support us. And speaking of support, I want to thank Marvel for hooking us up with the review copy. We like to be transparent about that, so you can determine what we think about that, you know, how much of how full of it we are because of that. And then, of course, thank you for watching. Now, if you're into Spider-Man, Marvel, comics in general, check us out every single day at graphicpolicy.com. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Tumblr, all Graphic Policy, keeping it nice and consistent. So until next time, keep reading those comics. Keep it geeky. Hey, thanks for watching the previous video from Graphic Policy Television. Just by watching, you help support our site. Thank you so much. Now, if you're watching these videos, you probably care about geeky things like movies, television, comic books, toys, games, video games, you name it. You can go and subscribe right now to our YouTube channel to stay in touch and catch all the new videos, or check out our website at graphicpolicy.com. There's a nice link on this end of the video. But as always, thank you for watching. Keep on rocking and keep it geeky.